Hey, guys, you remember that last match we played and it didn't go really well at all and it was kind of painful for all of us? You know what happens? We get to the B list of Warzone. We can't even get like Bowman on the desk. They have to find two scrubs to come over and help us. Let me be honest. Bar's probably missing a wine tasting at this point, and Payson probably just woke up. I'm gonna be honest with you. Payson's hair, I can never tell, but normally when it's too crazy, he's probably just woke up. We're playing Coho and Cameron. Coho claims to see movies. I think he just logs movies and like clicks play and then stops. And then Cam will know shit without watching any movies whatsoever. Like he'll just magically pull stuff. So we're gonna have to have the lead in this match at some point. So do that for me. That'd be great. And then at the end, they're going to hit a 4-point like animation question that they've never seen the movie, but they passed around as a Secret Santa gift. So let's try to hit it. Let's try to win. Let's play. Sound good?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's play.
All right, look, we're back in Movie Warzone Teams. It's been a while. This is gonna be fun. I'm actually been looking forward to this since we lost to Clash or Clash lost to Second Reel again. We can only lose to Concept and Second Reel. I think that's the rule of Warzone Teams. So I feel pretty okay about this today. How you feeling?
Yeah, I feel good. We've only lost to teams that have held the belt. That's a
Yeah.
streak that we've somehow managed to keep up through four losses.
Yep.
But
One of them
you'll
in a
see how
title
it goes.
match.
Last time, we ended up making the error of picking a strength we weren't 100% prepared for. I think we hopefully fixed that.
Yes. Yes,
Yeah.
we did. I think we got a good shot. This will be fun. Manage make a van, let's play.
What's up, everyone? Welcome back to another episode of Multiplex Movie Warzone. I'm Andrew the Dive Bar. That's Payson the Cinemaster Johnson. The inmates are running the asylum. I don't know what's going on anymore. Payson, how you feeling tonight?
I will neither confirm nor deny whether what Cody said about me waking up is true, but I'm very excited for this match tonight. We have a newer team versus an older team. It's going to be a very fun match.
Yeah, I am missing that wine tasting, but it's for a good reason. We have Excommunicado, Tyler Butler, and Antonio Chavez facing off against the Clash at Demonhead, Caleb Coho, and Cameron Holtzman. Clash at Demonhead having played for a title once before, but Excommunicado being a fresher team, so that energy could be really there, and especially after their last loss, probably looking to get some blood on their hands and take a match. But I say we bring them in. What do you say, Payson?
I'm good with that. Yeah, let's get them in.
All right. Introducing first, with a record of one win, one defeat, they are Antonio the Assassin Chavez and Tyler the Baba Yaga Butler, Excommunicado. And coming in next, with a record of four wins, four defeats, they are Cameron the Commander Holtzman and Caleb the King Coho. They are Clash at Demon Head. And we do that.
I was going to say, is this the part where I tell you that we don't do intros and we just bring people in now?
That's correct. Speaking of
Yeah,
which,
fine.
no, you had your turn. Speaking of which, we are going to go right into round number one. Round number one being your standard whiteboard round. You're going to get eight questions in eight different categories in the movie trivial realm. Each question that you get correct will be worth 1 point. If you miss it, that's okay. If a player gets all eight questions correct, they will be asked a bonus question, also worth 1 point. So I ask Excommunicado, are you ready?
Yep.
And Clash of Demonhead, are you ready?
Yep.
Sure.
All right, then I'm going to start you off with your first question coming in the category of war. The English Patient takes place during what war? The standard, what war does this take place in question?
I was going to say the same thing. Although I will say, with both you and I hosting, I can say we're probably both equally mad that this movie beat Fargo for Best Picture.
Five, absolutely. Four, three, that's a crime. Two, one. Pens down. Let's start with Holtzman
World War II.
and Antonio
World War II.
Coho
World War II.
and Tyler.
Said World War One.
World War II is correct. So Payson, why don't you take them to their next question?
Absolutely. Your next question will be coming in the category of actors and actresses. Who has played a real-life actress, a queen, and a folk singer?
Go ahead.
If you had to be any of those three, which would you want to be?
A folk singer. Oh, there's no doubt in my mind, even though Queen is very tempting.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Pens down. Antonio, we'll start with you.
Kate Blanchett.
And Coho?
Kate Blanchett.
And Tyler?
Kate Blanchett.
And Holtzman?
Kate Blanchett.
Clean sweep.
All right. With that, we're going to go into your next question, which is going to come in recent releases. What film is about a woman who teams up with her estranged father to determine if her husband is cheating on her? So, do you have any estranged fathers?
No, but I do have a couple of cheating husbands.
Ah, that I do too. 5. Yeah. Everyone does. 4. 3, 2, 1. Pens down. Let us start with Coho.
On the Rocks.
And Tyler.
Nothing.
Cameron.
Coho's right, yep.
And Antonio.
Nothing.
Coho getting that correct with On the Rocks. As we go into question number 4.
Yes, your next question will be coming to you in the category of directors. Who directed Moonstruck?
Very simple question.
Have you ever looked at, like, the full moon and been like, damn, girl, I'm starstruck?
5, 4. No, but it has hit my eye like a big pizza pie. 2, 1. Pens down. Let us start with Tyler.
Nothing again.
All right, Holtzman.
It's a very poorly written Mike Nichols.
Antonio.
I just guessed you were a woman.
And Coho.
I said Gary Marshall.
We're not going to get any perfect rounds today, unfortunately. The correct answer was Norman Jewison.
That guy.
One of those directors.
One of the best directors, but we'll argue about that later. Your next question is going to come in Mystery Thriller. Where is Joe Gillis's body found in Sunset Boulevard? Have you ever been to Sunset Boulevard? It's a beautiful place.
I think I've driven past there. I've heard very good things. Yes.
Well, that's a brag because I've never actually been there. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let us start with Holtzman.
Swimming pool.
Antonio.
Never seen it in a coffin.
Coho.
Pool.
And Tyler.
Pool.
That is correct.
Swimming pool is correct. All right, your sixth question will be coming to you in the category of movie release dates. What year saw the release of the family films Kangaroo Jack, The Lizzie McGuire Movie, and Daddy Daycare? One of these teams will be making a certain faction member very sad if they miss it.
Fair. That's a good point. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Start with Antonio.
2004.
And Coho.
2003.
Tyler.
2002.
And Holtzman.
2003.
2003 is correct. All right, your next question is going to come in sci-fi fantasy. In Total Recall, what planet does Quaid say he wants to travel to for his recall vacation? Total Recall, the name of the game here. You have to recall the movie totally.
All of the information.
All of it, just like scream it into your eyes.
A fan league that called themselves Total Recall.
5, 4. 3, 2, maybe 1. Let's start with Coho.
I guess Mars.
And Tyler.
Mars.
Holtzman.
Mars.
And Antonio.
Get your ass to Mars.
Get your ass to Mars, indeed.
And your final question will be coming to you in the category of the 70s. Who stars as actor Elliot Garfield in The Goodbye Girl?
Goodbye, girl. Oh, wait. I think that's the wrong words.
That's fair. I'd have nothing. I was gonna say
you don't know the Dixie Chicks? How dare, or the Chicks, as they're called now? Five, four, three.
For the Indigo Girls.
One. Let's start with Tyler.
Guest, Elliot Gould.
And Holtzman.
Is it Richard Dreyfuss?
Antonio.
I love Natalie Maines, by the way. Paul Newman.
And Coho.
I, too, guess Richard Dreyfuss.
Richard Dreyfuss is correct.
Nice.
All right. With that, I have a score of 13-6. Payson, is that what you have?
That is exactly what I have.
All right. With that, we are going to go into round two, which is affectionately known as our wheel round. You will get to spin the wheel. Whatever it lands on, you can either take that or you have to respin. If you respin, you do have to take the category that you land on that second time. Questions are worth 2 points, unless you go to multiple choice, in which case they will be worth 1 point. But look out. Steals are available. So you can be a criminal and get away with it this time. Clash of Demon Head, you are in the lead. I will give you your categories before you get to choose if you go first or second. Your categories today are Dwayne Johnson and Harrison Ford, which are excommunicado strength, 21st century live-action musicals, and 21st century screenplay Oscar winners, which are Clash of Demon Head strength, as well as scores and soundtracks, 90s, coming-of-age-slash-teen, crime, and spinners and opponent's choice. So Clash of Demon Head, would you like to go first or second?
Second.
Yeah. I was going to say, right. Unless we want to try and Jacoby it.
No, that's fine.
All right, we're going to bring Excommunicado's manager in then. And here is your spin. First screenplay Oscar winners.
Spin it again.
Yeah.
Figured as much. And away we go.
There we go.
You get Harrison Ford.
Be smart. They studied some, so don't just shoot. Okay.
All right.
Unless you know.
Andrew, would you like me to take these, or would you like to take these?
Payson, since you asked so nicely, why don't you take these?
Thank you so much, Master. All right. Excommunicado. 5 questions, and Harrison Ford. Your first question: who directed 6 Days, 7 Nights?
I think it was Ivan Reitman.
Yeah, I'm going to go with that. Go with that. Yeah.
Ivan Reitman, final answer?
That is correct for 2 points. Your second question. In what film does Ford star alongside Gary Oldman and Luke Hemsworth?
Oops. Correction, Liam Hemsworth. Liam Hemsworth.
Okay. Damn, I'll know it if it's multiple choice. I keep forgetting the freaking title. Do you know it?
No, not offhand.
Multiple choice, then.
All right, your multiple choice options. Is it A, Paranoia, B, Extraordinary Measures, C, Firewall, or D, Morning Glory?
I think it's the first one.
Yeah, it's the first one. A.
Paranoia.
Paranoia.
A, Paranoia is correct for 1 point.
So bad.
Holtzman is correct. Your third question. In Witness, what does Samuel see that leads him to identify Lieutenant McPhee as the killer?
It's in a. Oh man,
it's in the like bathroom. I know that, but anybody
four,
know
place? Repeat. Three, two.
Repeat. Okay. In Witness, what does Samuel see that leads him to identify Lieutenant McPhee as the killer?
So I don't know how specific it's supposed to be, because he looks, he goes over to like a trophy case or something like along the lines where he like sees a picture of him and it like identifies him as like a police officer. So
Yeah, you're right. So yeah, trophy case.
So he sees a photo of him in like a trophy case.
Yeah.
One.
Yeah, for another.
I heard final answer. Can we accept that bar? I heard picture in a trophy case. I'm going to say incorrect.
So,
I'm kind of the opposite way.
Okay, then we will give you 2 points. That is correct for 2 points.
Okay, so then I'll start talking to Coho. So it's specifically a newspaper article. It's a newspaper clipping. It's not just a photograph of him. It's a newspaper clipping about him.
Is it in a trophy case?
It's hanging on the wall.
All right. If you want to challenge it, if you think there's grounds, all right, go for it.
Challenge.
All right. We will look into this challenge, and we will be right back after this. All right, so after the challenge, we have come to the conclusion that there is a photo in the clipping, and it is in a trophy case, so we will be giving Excommunicado the 2 points. And moving on, we will be going to question...
question number four in Harrison Ford. Excommunicado, this is your penultimate question. In what city does the beginning of Patriot Games take place?
I believe he's overseas. No, it's not. I don't think he's in the United States.
No, it's in Europe.
I think it's London.
I think we have to go to multiple choice.
Sure.
Yeah. Multiple choice.
All right. Your multiple choice options. Is it A, Paris, B, Istanbul, C, Berlin, or D, London?
So, yeah, I'm going with London.
London? Okay. Cause, so, yeah, it's like the Queen's Guard and everything. So,
yeah.
So, okay, so yeah.
London.
That is correct for 1 point. And your final question? What military ranking does Ford's character have in Apocalypse Now?
Damn. I haven't seen it in a long time, so.
Me neither.
So, probably your multiple choice again.
Do you want to go for it with a multiple choice?
All right, your multiple choice options. Is it A, Major, B, Colonel, C, Lieutenant, or D, Captain?
I feel like it's Colonel.
I'm leaning towards the last two because he's not that high of a ranking.
Mm-hmm.
I was leaning towards Captain.
Okay, let's go Captain.
All right, Captain, final answer.
One. Clash at Demon Head, the chance for a 1 point steal. Is it A, Major, B, Colonel, C, Lieutenant, or D, Captain?
I think it is Colonel.
I will trust you. I just remember it being something lower ranking.
Yeah.
So.
Colonel, final answer.
That is correct for a 1 point steal.
Oh, wow. Sorry.
Right. I just knew you stole George Lucas's last name.
All right. So with that, we are going to Clash at Demon Head spin. So the score right now is 14 to 12, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes, and it was not mentioned earlier, but yes. I did just want to mention Clash at Demon Head. You guys have lost your challenge.
Yes. All right, so here is your first spin. Coming of age / teen.
I think it's good, but we... already have the lead. We might as well spin again.
Might as well, yeah.
Yeah, spin again.
All right. Nope, you're gonna spin that again.
Cool.
Would have loved those quests.
Me too. I felt pretty good about that.
Oh, God.
Just hitting spinners.
Musicals?
Choice.
Musicals.
Musicals,
yeah,
my good man. We'll take
live action musicals, please.
Okay. So I will be giving you those questions. All right, Clash at Demon Head, your first question in 21st Century Live Action Musicals. Who plays Mayor Whitmore in Rock of Ages?
That's Bryan Cranston.
Go for it.
Bryan Cranston, final answer.
That is correct for 2 points. Your second question. What 2010s musical was directed by Michael Gracey?
That's The Greatest Showman.
Yep.
The Greatest Showman, final answer.
2 more points. What is the first name of Jeremy Jordan's character in the last 5 years?
Jamie.
Jamie, final answer.
That is correct. Okay. And your last question. Around what holiday? Sorry, question number four. The one is in big block, so I... All right. Around what holiday is Angel's funeral in Rent?
Halloween. It's Halloween because he sings the song Halloween right after it.
You're right.
Halloween, final answer.
That is two more points. And so we are in a position here where if Clash at Demon Head gets a point, they will win by knockout. However, Excommunicado will have that chance to steal if they do get it wrong. So your fifth and final question in 21st Century Live Action Musicals. What musical features songs such as All I Ask of You and Wishing You Were Somehow Here Again?
The Phantom of the Opera. Final answer.
And your winner by knockout, Clash at Demon Head. All right, with a score of 24-12, we'll be going right into the post-match interviews, starting with our unfortunate second-place finishers today, Excommunicado. Let me bring your manager in. There he is. So, Excommunicado, that was unfortunate, but you guys were putting up a really great fight towards the end of your second round.
Please. Gosh.
I was trying to be nice.
I'm a host trying to paint something nice, or how you... We got knocked out. That's like putting perfume on a dead person. Like, please leave us alone. We're already in pain. Cool. Yeah. You know, as a manager, you pair up people and you're like, this will work. And this team just doesn't work fully together at times. And it sucks. It's two knockouts. We didn't score enough in round one to compete. It was just it's a little rough. We're still going to be in the tournament. It's going to play a higher seed. It's going to be a little bit rough. I think they can work. It's just they talked each other out of two correct answers. It's just I need adamant. I just need yelling, but no, it's this. I know it. Let's go. And there wasn't. It was just unfortunate. Clash is a really good team. And again, musicals. We got musicals last time, got us knocked out, and they get musicals to knock us out. So we don't like the singing and the dancing here in the first order. So, and Holtzman, listen, I'm just going to make this a blatant statement for everybody. There's other musicals than the last 5 years. I've never seen the movie, but listen, I hear that question brought up every time there's a musical. I don't know what it is about, but listen, stop it. I don't even think it's a good musical. I don't know what we're doing, but let's try to focus on different musicals.
I agree.
Holtzman, watch some older movies, all right? I'm tired of hearing about these young, like these 21st century. Get better. You guys, movies started before the 2000s. Go back. Watch some movies. Please, watch some films. This is a great time to be alive. I'm so happy to be here. I'm going to go now because I don't want to see either one of your faces, and I definitely don't want to hear from Coho or Holtzman. So we'll see you in the tournament, but I'm out. You can talk to them, but I'm leaving. Bye.
Okay, I guess that's it. Well, thank you guys for coming. All right. Any last thoughts?
No, they played a good game. Like, kind of expected it was going to go this way, but yeah.
Okay. Well, we will be seeing you again. So there is that. You do have another match coming up. So we will be seeing you again.
All right, sounds good.
Thank you guys for coming. All right, now we will be going over to our winners today. The Clash at Demon Head. You guys are a little bit nicer than Cody, so I will ask you, how do you feel?
I feel pretty good. I feel bad. Yeah. Because I like Tyler and Antonio. I feel bad doing that to this team because I like both of them. I don't feel bad at all doing that to Cody. That felt great. But to those two, that felt a little. I'm sorry. We've beaten Antonio twice now by a good margin, and that I feel bad. This just feels mean. But at this point, that felt like a great comeback. I feel really good right now personally. So I feel I feel like,
yeah, no, it's nice to get that win and get back into a positive record. And the fact that it happens to be a knockout is just icing on the cake. Like we were talking today and we were like, okay, like if we have the lead, this, if we don't, how do we rearrange everything? And then it was like, oh, we panicked and we didn't really need to.
Yeah, I guess.
But,
I don't
yeah,
know.
It just like Cody says, for me to watch stuff that's older, I'm trying, but until I've watched enough of it and I feel good about it, I'm going to keep using these 21st century
ones. If it ain't broke, we ain't fixing it.
Yeah. We, like I said, last time we picked strengths, we did not fully know. We fixed that mistake this time. And then, yeah, my Letterboxd stats do the opposite of thanking Antonio and Tyler. Harrison Ford is now easily my most watched actor of all time on Letterboxd. And Dwayne Johnson is number 4. So
good things. Good things came out of it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, well,
okay.
So, you guys are going to have...
I will say no thank you because I watched Be Cool and fuck that movie. So no thank you.
It's not a good movie.
Not a good movie at all.
The Rock is good in it, but he's not. But it's not a very good movie.
All right. Well, with that being said, you guys are – we will also be seeing you guys in the tournament. You will be having a little bit of a higher seed. Who do you guys want to play? Who are you hoping to play?
So there was a match that filmed recently in which the people that won it said, oh, well, who do we want to play in the tournament? We want to play, quote, one of the lower-tier Kingsman teams. I don't know if they're talking about us. The two main – there's – three main Kingsman teams, and it's us, Double Indemnity, and Blockbuster Video, and sure as hell, none of the three of us are lower tier teams. So I'd love a chance to kick that team's teeth in. I'm not going to name them, but they know who they are.
I also have heard about this little team. I don't know. There's this guy on it. His name's Kirk, and this one guy even lower than the boots of the sand that one walks on named Andrew Barr. I TKO'd his ass once. I'd like to KO it straight up this time. And I've got some personal business to settle with Mr. Kolakowski. So give me bullets over Broadway. I'd like to knock them out next.
You know, you can take that to your 2-point Emerald City question and go home. All right. With that being said.
I'm winning on you now, bitch. I'm winning on you now, bitch.
That was luck. All right. So. With that being said, we will see you later. I will see you later. Payson, those were fire closing thoughts. What are your closing thoughts, and are we going to add more fire to this?
I'm just going to leave it with some words that Cody said that I think we can all take into account. Watch more movies.
You know what? Words of wisdom. Cody sometimes gets it right. With that being said, for Payson, for Antonio, for Tyler, for Cody, for Coho, for Holtzman, and for myself, this has been Multiplex Movie War Zone, and we're going to edit up the rest of this. I'm going to play the thing. Where is it? Where is it? No! I'm the worst at this. God.
I am making it worse.
They're gonna keep this, I swear to God. There it is.
It's not unusual.
Bye bye, boys.
Have fun storming the castle.
Think it'll work?
It would take a miracle.
Bye bye.